Sorry, that was not a clean cut. We'll call Lumi and let's get this show started.
MVPs turn to bat.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back. It's more the Mars TV Dota 2 League. It was a bit of a break right there, but we are in.
Five seconds remaining.
No, I hear you, bro. I hear you.
Admiral Konkar.
MVP's turn to pick.
That's good. Yeah. Because up to this point, it was feeling like MVP was like, we're going to play our game, we're going to do our MVP thing, and not... I'm sure they respect their opponents, but based on the draft, it didn't really look like it, but now they are, and they respect it just the way Secret respect them, banning out the silencer. Does allow an Oracle to slip through, and I want to say that this might be the first Oracle of the day for me, at least. So we'll have to see. It's been a lot of fun, and it definitely limits a lot of heroes from being picked up. What was once a very popular Batrider might not look so good anymore, Lumi.
Reserve time.
And Omni-Man.
Team Secret's turn to pick.
Yeah, that's probably part of the reason that this hero is seriously on the up and up. I mean, some few, you know, really saw the potential. I mean, when he first came out, it was absolutely ridiculous. If you're talking about the whole false promise with the invis, with like 10 second cooldown, that was when it was out of control. They nerfed him down a bit. And then, you know, to some, they looked at him, they're like, he's a bit complex. I don't even know how to, you know, I don't even know what his abilities do. I don't know which abilities what. But now that people are, you know, once he came into captain's mode, obviously they want to learn the hero, and his true potential has really been unleashed. What do you think, Lumi? Do you think that it deserves attention to the Mighty Frog? Maybe nerf him down a bit?
Keeper of the Light.
MVP's turn to bat. Team Secret's turn to ban.
Yep.
MVP's turn to ban.
Yeah.
Team Secret's turn to ban.
That is really where he's been seeing most of his time recently, too, which is surprising. I mean, TI was the top pickup to go in the offlane for sure, but yeah, as of recent, Manta Diffusal, safe lane farming Faceless Void has pretty much been on repetition here, so can't help but acknowledge that Secret, by the way, picked up the greatest hero in the game, of course, the Keeper of the Light, you know, a formidable support, I'll be one of the best at it, should be a good time. Yeah.
Reserve time.
Bounty Hunter.
Team Secret's turn to pick.
Yeah, right? Oh, going for the bounty. Oh, yeah.
Phantom Assassin.
MVP's turn to pick.
It's quite ridiculous. I love him in overthrow too. I've been abusing him in overthrow, straight ags and sniping all the kills. But like, I'm one of like 20 people who play that game still, so it's quite unfortunate. But PA is going to be picked up here, this time by Secret, not MVP. So we'll be interested to see what they can do with it. This is no four position shenanigans here. Seems to be a clear cut, straightforward core, and you know, something that we used to see for Epic play, I would imagine, quite a bit. So seeing him play it now with the secret jersey, interesting. And yeah, should be a good time.
Reserve time. MVPs turn to ban. Team secrets turn to ban.
Yeah. And more often than not, I'm seeing PA do those ridiculous crits where she just insta-deletes flimsy little oracles or any support, and you can't help but just get in their face and be like, I bet you didn't see that one coming. It's just ridiculous. So, we'll see. Secret, maybe they've been praying to RNGesus and something will work out for him here. Timbersaw being the follow-up, I imagine that should be the mid-one grab. We saw him do wonderful work with this on Fnatic back at TI, and, you know, it just kind of matches the high tempo pace. I mean, I can't help feel like it's a little, like, you keep one side. When I look at Viper, I don't know if you get to keep the same way I do, and I do have both play hero, so we look at him, but he's like stall slow, can draw games out, but that seems a bit conflicting with you now, a PA and a Timbersaw. I know he has a lot of tools that just bring to the game, but I couldn't help but notice that it's just going to be a bit interesting to see that. The pacing he wants to go at is different.
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Team secrets turn to pick.
You know what? Actually, I was looking at it, and I think Pi is going to be playing this keeper. And I think, I was like, the way I'm like, oh, this place to puppy coddle. But it's like, no, Pi plays it too. And the funny thing is that I actually really liked Pi a lot. I know who he was, much about him, even what he looked like on his Twitter. His Twitter had Keeper of the Light as the avatar, and I think still does. I was like, I like this guy already. So I know he plays a really good coddle based on that alone. Their final pickup to be the Storm, who also happens to synergize wonderfully with the Keeper, does tell me now, obviously, it's not going to the mid-1 Timber, though. Now I'm on Storm.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Oh no. Suddenly a wild card here. Oh, this is crazy. But typically PA is not terrible against Huskar. I guess it depends if he's able to kind of... I mean, if it's a... If Huskar has his way, it will be that point in time. But if she's able to build up into something special, she could have a say in a square-off match against the Huskar. This is going to be a doozy, and I couldn't help but giggle up there because I was thinking, brilliant little synergy. Can't forget the benefiting, like the double dagger play coming out from PA. That might be a bit of a doozy in the early game. That'd be a lot of fun to see. Yeah.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Yeah. I wonder. I actually didn't catch the final bands there, and I couldn't help but think, you know, obviously I had forgotten. I mean, I guess we were caught up on talking about Cuddle a lot, talking about the other things that I didn't think of the Huskar at all, and I can't help but wonder if Secret didn't think about the Huskar at all. MVP managed to snap one up, or something that Secret had already considered and were willing to welcome into this game three. Yeah. How about the potential laning setup here? I would imagine that we once again be blessed by Bello going off lane. Actually, last time he went straight to the jungle and they just sacked the off lane altogether. Is that something we could likely be seeing again here? Is that worth it to him? I mean, that would just leave what I imagine being the PA to kind of own devices at the bottom lane. Oh, don't do this to me. You totally. Oh my god. It's, you know. It's definitely not OD. Oh, it's Storm. It's Storm. That's right. I didn't even look at chat. I knew that one. I pulled it out. Okay. Whew. I got so caught up and still thinking mid one was Timber. That totally threw everything off. But what you think? It's gotta be Storm mid, I'd imagine, right? I mean. Oh, yeah. Yeah. He can go to the jungle and have a happy little time there. I don't obviously foresee too much Coddle roaming around. Coddle will be happy because then it's like, oh, I could just do the pool camp thing and I'll be here by myself and I could just do that and I will get fast levels real, you know, and we know how much Coddle benefits from just getting so much early XP and getting those levels fast. Having a level 3, you know, chakra magic so much sooner. I would imagine he wouldn't probably put too much into Melee League early if he doesn't even have a offline opponent to really go against, so he'll blast much sooner, he'll get far much sooner, and that's when he gets closer to that very tasty, juicy Agnum Scepter, so. But I wonder what that means for the Kunkka, if he's going to try to, you know, make an impression in the mid lane, or roam around and try to keep tabs on the Axe. I know we're, like, totally theorycrafting this whole early laning phase. I know, like, someone had to go take a deuce or something. Oh, it looks like we're back. Okay. And away we go. All right, call them out. Yeah, that's a good feeling for Fed. He's like, yes, all right, they can't come in here, they can't come into my house and drop that ward. Now they already have their own ward down. They would see any sort of infiltration like that, and he can keep that pull camp sacred and kind of be in the know-how if there's going to be any rotation. So Febby's in for a good time now, and it looks like Storm is going mid. Is it mid? Yep. You're right. All right, I don't know. I want to avoid those freaking spears every time I'm around them. He's ready for daggers coming his way, but not the case. Okay. Maybe that's just secret, like, well, if he's not extra prepared for Storm, maybe they're just confident enough if he wants skills. I'm pretty sure that's what EG's motto was also, like, through TI5, like, pulling out Storm, even at times where it looked like Storm wasn't really even a thing. You know, they're just confident enough in Sumail's capability that he'll be able to win the lane more often than not. Maybe they have this faith in Midwan, we'll see. That's nice. He's winning right now. But he's got to be careful, because it's not just Huskar. It's also Bounty Hunter, who dropped his own sentry. Convenient puppy show, though, as he pops on in with a torrent and with a dust. Not getting close enough, though, to be able to do the work. And goes for a torrent. Nice backpedal there by Du. It's going to be able to avoid it. That was such a surprise play there by Puppy. Very nice interjection. Yeah.
Denied.
Good win right there for Puppy, and Dubu is just gonna be left wondering if he should hang around and try to go for the sentry again, or just make an impression elsewhere. It seems like it could be the latter as he heads up to the top. As expected, as we were talking about during the pause, Bell is straight to the jungle. And starting his farm path there. That will leave the lane totally open for Ferev to be farming on his Timbersaw. Yeah, so.
First blood. I accept this honor on behalf of Storm's every X.
Yeah, still creeping around. He managed to pop a torrent there onto QO, and I guess QO decided to man up there. Did get the, kill there in the end with the help of the Flaming Spears, got damage, but obviously going down first, handing over the XP burst to Midwan is not the best thing ever. But Midwan is also sharing XP with P here and there, so they are still matching out pretty evenly. Dubu already guarding out the rune. He'll grab it himself. That prompts the dust, prompts the X into a torrent. Oh, Dubu waiting for the rune, but Secret were waiting for an opportunity to catch him waiting. I think. That sounded confusing. Yep, that is not working out to be a favorable matchup, and that might be the last time we could see him in that lane, as he probably heads back to the jungle to look for better farm opportunities there. Speaking of making a return here, Dude back in the mid lane, but again, he will quickly realize that there's still a sentry in that mid lane, and he cannot sneak in there and get any sort of jabs in. So. He will definitely be watching the replay and being like, where was f***ing Ward at? Okay. Torque connection here for QO. That's some good damage, but QO welcomes the damage and looks into the mid one. Has to be careful. Another torque connection could lead to some trouble. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, Midwan now caught between three. The spear's going to come out. He's going to be able to get it done. Now looks for Puppy here. It's a lot of burn damage. He would definitely need maybe another couple. Is it good enough? Is it good? Is he roasting? Is he toasting? Is he burnt? He's burnt. Oh, that sounded painful. All right. Puppy goes down, and suddenly the game's back even. 3-3. No, I'm totally like right there with you. Like, I've noticed that kind of a thing for MVP is that they always seem to have this power 3 core here. Well, top lane one of those cores, Febby, able to sidestep the blast. The basics come in, just in time it would appear, and now the heals begin to come out, but they just seem to have the three cores, like, each kind of matching up with each other. Febby's, you know, on the Silencers, he was on the Drow Ranger with, you know, like, kind of interesting build-up, but, I mean, he's not, like, the one-man kind of core carry, so MVPs have this balance between this trinity, and it seems to be working out for the most part, but we'll have to see if it works out here for Game 3. We're hoping to see if the Dubu Bounty Hunter was also going to be in the area. Not the case, as Dubu had a back door, but yeah, nice quick prompt rotation. Looks like we're expecting, just in case, a Valiant jumping from QO. They would have a TP at the ready. It allowed the Timbersaw to kind of make his move and his first real impression outside of the bottom lane. This does open up the bottom lane for Vela to kind of quickly get back on track because he's about to get through his level 7. Obviously not the gross early farm that he had in the previous game, but nonetheless, still looking to make track and try to get underway towards the Link Dagger. QO back at the mid lane now, and we'll see. As it's closer to this armlet, Huskar begins to take off eventually, and then we'll have to see where QO goes from there. Now, for Ev, though, he also goes down. Ryzen's able to kind of blast him apart with the help of the Purifying Flames. Then they quickly focus onto him. King Chase, blast flying through. It's a puny little blast, but it's good enough to be able to add that extra bit of peppering damage. Midwan will get the last hit in, and that's a secret. Picking it right back up as they make a 3-for-1 trade. A great rotation in by Ev, but even though he does go down, he certainly helped in that fight right back in a round. They need the timbers up there for this Huskar. Yeah, definitely. With Pi showing up there at the end, that's all 5. Oh no, yeah, that was all 5.
Radiant structures are fortified.
Oh yeah, he's even worse than Drow by far. Like, definitely just probably the most highest momentum dependent in the game, I would say. So, but you have a quarter to me, an armlet that should be in line, and obviously he with a huge power spike at that, and you wait for the follow up when you're supposed to get the Fall Promise online. And then it's time to go here for MVP, and if they're able to put all that together, along with this track coming out from the Bounty Hunter, I mean, you could tell they kind of put this all together so that hit this huge monster moment, you know, X Blink on top of that too, Chrono, like, it all needs to happen at once, or I think we'll just take the game right back, and MVP will not have a say in the matter. Cute little jump behind there by Ferev. Blocks out Febby, and Febby will excuse himself from land and go back to where the creeps belong. And we check out back and below. We've had a free lane here for QO for quite a while, so I'm sure they're kind of passing the memo along that Midwan has also been missing. As he's gone and taking business in the jungle on the side, he's also getting a really good moment where he can kind of find some business elsewhere on the map. As Ball Lightning is up, and I would imagine with his next level, we'll probably go for the Vortex and consider some new opportunities in the horizon. But
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Oh yeah. Comes with that, and like I would imagine the armlet buildup. And well, he's got a battle sooner than he wants though, as he gets caught in the bad side of a call. Both just fly through it though, so does the dunk. And that's gonna get Bell Nab. Here comes Ferev looking to make their jump on the Febby. Making a jump, so there's QO moving on in, looking to go for MP. The brightest light ever blocking my screen right now, but there goes QO. False Promise is gonna hit up and Pi has to run on back. But that burned so hard. Will it be enough for the takedown? Well, yes it will. Well, one last right click to get it from Febby. Meanwhile, Ferev will get that finish onto Huskar. A 3-for-2 trade. And Febby needs 10 more seconds before he can get a this time that okay, alright then. Fair enough. Time walk to the high ground. X pullback from Puppy. Time dilation. Making them four Dubu here now, and we'll start dishing out some track. Adds some move speed, and that will allow Febby to make it away. Woo. Oh yeah. Yeah, and he is always in a position where he likes to chase pretty often, and the chasing doesn't really happen once your mana leaked up. So that and being just pushed all over the place by Blinding Light, it's gonna be tough, and I don't foresee him kind of making his way towards any sort of way of really kind of dealing with the blind either. So this is. We'll have to see. QO, you could feel it as they head again down south, looking for opportunities. They know that they need to kind of be able to begin to take tier ones and control these fights, but oh my god. Alright, well, they're dead for sure, and this is going to be secret to the corner now. QO is stuck in a bit of an awkward spot, but here comes a jump from Febby. 10 seconds, though, before QO is going to be up. Ferev happy to dance right through him, but with the Spears continuing to chunk on out, they'll be able to burn through the Timbers and take him down. Alright, that's a nice nab, but losing both your supports to start things off, unfortunately doesn't make it good. But please look at Spin now, and they'll eventually get the burst on Pi. Now Febby on the run. Ferev not done yet, looking to rush on in, and okay. What happened there? Purify Flame gets bursted up. It looked like he would deal with Fate's Edict, but just too much burst. Yeah.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
I have to assume at the end of the day, MVP cannot feel satisfied with where they are in the game right now. I mean, certainly need to be on the up and up. I mean, it obviously goes without saying, the stigma is there. You have a Huskar, you have to really be the ones in control, but I've only been seeing Secret really kind of taking the best moments in these skirmishes. And here they are looking to go on the offensive once again. QO needs to be careful here. Look at that. Offensive setup from Pi, bumping back with the Blinding Light, allows Ferev to shred on forward here. QO going to be going down, and they make it look effortless, and they will just walk out away. Just the tag team taking out the biggest power hitter, and where all the eggs are put in on the Huskar basket. Secret totally in control. The problem is they have so much trouble with these four. As the boat flies forward and Ferev just says, utter destruction. The boat also connects. The Q level will get the false promise. He's going to try to do his damage to stay alive. But look at him. Caught in a chakra. Too much damage. He is down for sure. MP has shown himself in the fight. And he said that you had to work out the rest of my team, but I am finally here to play. And he squares up, gets a nice, cute little crit onto his former teammate and sends Febby away. And this is not boding well. QO goes down once again. They're finally able to bring down the Timber Saw, but the point I was going to make before the fight broke out is they were having trouble with everyone else. MP wasn't even getting involved, but now he's involved and he has a Desolator. Wow. Torrent to chain through, to jump in from mid one. It's just nowhere feeling safe now for MVP. Just look at these wards too from Secret, just littered throughout the mid lane. Viewage up and above the Roche towards the Ancient Candle. See Dubu come down. They already pinged out his ward. Oh, MVP is going to be shut in the dark here soon. And with the momentum just continuing to slow down, I mean, that period I was hoping for, you know, I was calling out for the axe, the blink dagger coming online, the chrono, the track money, none of this happened. None of it, unfortunately, for MVP. On cue. Well, let's see. I mean, MVP can't help but feel like they're reaching a bit here, but they'll let Dubu head out in front. Secret are a little further away, hanging around the mid lane, still kind of rendezvousing together. They are going to go for their own smoke flow here. All right, interesting enough. No Secret. Comb up and around, but as we all know, MVP far from there. So it looks like teams just kind of doing the classic Dosai on each other. Unless Dubu heads up this way. Looks like we could have some action. Puppies in biz, but he has a tree. Spot out Dubu. They're going to pop the dust. They move on in. Febby shows himself. Can't decide if he wants to pop out the Chrono yet. Yeah, we'll go for the time. Dilation. Then pops out the Chrono. Looking to go for mid one. Kubo jumps from the low ground. But man, Torrent and the boat and the black hole coming out. Seeks going for their own response. The false promise will be there for QO. How much damage is he able to get up though? Is he going to be alive? He's good. Stays alive. Looks one. Blast continue to chunk out though for Pi. And Ferev brings in the deeps with the double kill now. They get through four. They're going for Fanny to make it five. With the mana leak, he may not be getting away. He goes down. That's all five out. They only get mid one. Oh. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Oh boy. Dire's middle tower has fallen. Now, even then, the disrespect from Pi, just don't go for that. Hits him with a blinding light, the mana leak, he loses all of his mana, and because he's ridiculed like that, he'll walk away. And now Secret control of Roche, and they know that's what they need to go for next. And with a sentry down, they will get rid of the MVP high ground ward, and it's all under Roche for them. Here comes trouble, and just like that, he loses pretty much 3/4 of his life. QO realizes he's in the best spot, and he's got to get back and away here. A jump in does come out from Bello. They'll go for MP, but that leads to Torrent, a two-man blast, but no boat connection there. Debbie jumps back out and away, but It's focused on Ferev here as he jumps way behind the MVP team. They're going to be able to get the call off. Self Lotus, but there's going to be the Chrono only to hold Ferev and to keep the ups back, I suppose. But nonetheless, it gets the finish for the server. MVP feeling like this is their best opportunity to come back. They will look for any opportunity to move on forward. But I think they've... this is ambitious. Very ambitious for MVP. Because Secret, as mentioned, are back. And they're moving in. Bella with little mana to work with. And Fedigno Chrono. Okay, okay. To the high ground. We've seen this before. Fedigno above, but Husk held up down. So, thank goodness. But this false promise. How lift is going to be. Eating some damage now. Been triple high. Will be able to slice down the horizon. Takes him apart. Cube cops want to rest the Secret. That's going to lead to Roche. I don't think MVP are going to be holding on to the game too much longer. This is a stagious Secret continues in this game. It's been really a lot of Timbersaw. The Timbersaw show. I mean, he warranted a serious amount of respect, and he deserves so through TI, but it seems like he's still in such a place right now. I imagine he's just going to be possibly one of the power picks for the tournament throughout this event. We saw him in every day, right? I want to say so. Maybe. Yeah. Man, he lost like half his life from Pi's blast alone, and sure enough, Puppy be behind him to catch him DX. That only leads to his demise, and now he's out of the equation for about 30 seconds. Here comes Secret now, confidently out the front door of MVP's home. Look at the closing guy. Look to take aim and get into the part of the playoffs. Of the bracket. Putting to a top seed. But it's a bit slow. Oh no, never mind. Simple X to stop up and yeah, relieve away the pressure. Two ways, and this is a couple of times we've seen that. Kunkka and Kunkka together. I mean, you can really go anywhere you want, and you have to Uber waiting for it. Yep, it's wonderful. I love it. Please do more. I want to see more, please. Give MP Chakra Magic. There it is. Alright. Double dagger, double dagger, double dagger, double dagger. There we go. That's one. Second one. Again, no crits, unfortunately. Alright, bit of a bummer. Nonetheless. Very nice. And just like that, to quickly bandage up wounds here. Secret just kind of toying with them a bit, but... obviously know they are well in control, and we'll dip on back. There is still one more outer tower here for MVP in this bottom lane, so Secret will get back to Grindstone here and be able to push it down. And at that point, MVP will be stuck inside, and Secret will look for ways to be able to infiltrate here. I imagine they have some pretty good options, Lumi, being able to siege in. I mean, it's like a lot of the other games, Fred can often jump in, but we'll have to see. MVP... oh man, did this spotted pilot had a blinding light and just pieced out there. Fred knew what was happening. He just walked right into it, but turns in the middle, grabbing up Dubu, gets sliced up from Ferev. Solo with a jump in. They'll follow it up with the Chrono. A lot of hate here to get mid line. That's all for the Aegis. The buff back quelling. As they run back in, a blink out MP on the back end of a false. Can he make it away? He's good. Now it's going to be on to Velo here. Jump in from Minwon. Meanwhile, Ferev cleaning up elsewhere. And then they get the cleanup on to Ryzen. Ferev with the triple.
probably the final say for MVP as they clean house, a full five-man wipe. Secret lose nobody, with the exception of Agents. And now we're looking to close things out. He is just the greatest for, to be honest with you. But, I mean,